The Gixxer SF was a gamble that worked out well for Suzuki. Since then, the company has made sure that the motorcycle is regularly updated. Anik has been quite prolific in munching miles on his Gixxer SF and joins us today to share his ownership experience. Hi Anik, welcome to the show. Well, the Gixxer SF along with its naked sibling brought Suzuki back to life in India. So what made you choose this bike and how has your experience been with it?
Hey Swati, thank you for calling me over here. I actually want to thank you because after I started my YouTube channel, people have been asking me a lot about my tripping experience and my performance of my bike. So I think it's a great opportunity for me to tell everyone how my bike actually supported me all throughout my rides and all. I think I purchased my bike, and this is my first bike, so I purchased in 2015. So I had to go through a lot of YouTube videos and all in order to confirm ki okay, I had a lot of criteria about my bike. I wanted it with a good mileage, good performance, good looks. So in my hand, I had few Pulsar bikes, that is AS 150. There was Avenger 150, Hornet 160R, and this Gixxer. So I wanted to have a test ride of all the bikes and then select. So the moment I went to Suzuki Gixxer showroom, there was a bike parked over there. So there was a person who actually started the engine. The first look was the digital meter that I saw. It was like really good, and the sound of the engine. That was the first thing that attracted me a lot. And I thought, okay, let's give it a shot and I will just give the test ride. So the moment I gave a test ride, I just selected at that spot, that time that I want this bike. So that was the first impression that Gixxer gave me. And after that, I have gone through a lot of riding experience. On a daily basis, each and every day I travel with my bike. I have covered almost 39,000 kilometers till now. I think Gixxer exceeded all the expectation that I had at that point of time. And performance wise, if you ask me, I would say I'm quite satisfied with the performance Gixxer has given me.
Now, the Gixxer SF really got the pricing and the looks just right. So, how has your experience been with it in real life conditions?
So, performance wise, I think Gixxer has been a real support to me in my daily life. On a daily basis, I use my vehicle to go from my place to office. That's inside the city. And on a road trip, I have almost covered all the hill station of Karnataka till now. And the performance has been really good. The best part of handling and the engine is I have never faced any overheating of the engine. Whether I'm in a city or going on a long trip, the best handling part that I faced was in the hairpin bends. So I have gone to Ooty as well as Valparai, who has got 40 hairpin bends, and the handling is really good, as because of the light weighted vehicle, it's really easy for the rider to mold it in any way he like. He can twist the vehicle any way they like. No hitting, there was no overheating of engine at any part. Only once I have faced that one while I was coming back from Coimbatore. So at a stretch of 200 kilometers, I didn't give any stop or didn't give any brake to my vehicle. So that time I faced a little bit of overheating, but I stopped over there and took a break for 30 minutes and then again it was fine. So in the span of these 2 years, I have never faced a single bit of problem with the engine or maybe with any part of my vehicle. So experience till now, whether it's on a hill, whether it's on a city, is really good. And the mileage, whatever I expected, whatever Suzuki has claimed officially, is definitely true, because I get a mileage of around 45 on a highway, or in a city I get around 40. So that's very good enough for me. So I'm quite satisfied with the performance Suzuki Gixxer has given me.
Now, I have ridden the Gixxer and found it very light and easy to ride. So, how has your experience been with the fared version?
So, as I said, like the handling part of Gixxer is really good. The rider can easily twist and turn anywhere he likes. I have maximum time I have gone to the hill stations, which have got a lot of hairpin bends, and trust me, I have never faced a single bit of problem in doing all the twists and turns. As because it has got a very light weighted body, so it's really easy for the rider to like take the twist and turn. And I must say the tire, the grip of the tire is really good, which didn't, till now I didn't face any kind of problem while I take all these risky turns or maybe in the hairpin bends. I have never faced any kind of problem. The braking, the drawback I would say, as because I have a drum brake, in 2015 Gixxer didn't like launch with the double disc one. Right now in 2017 they have already done that one, so I think the drawback that they had in this bike, they already have made up to it, and they had a double disc. So I, other than that, it totally depends upon the biker or the rider how to use the brakes. For me, I have never faced a problem whether it's a disc or a drum. With the drum also, I am quite satisfied. The kind of movement or the kind of performance my bike used to give me, whether I am on a highway or I am on a hill, is really great. So till now, in this span of 2 years, I didn't face any problem regarding the handling or maybe the braking or the performance of my engine or the tire.
Now let's talk about your after-sales experience with Suzuki. Are there enough service centers, and are you happy with the service and support provided by the company?
So I must say, I bought this one from 9-star Suzuki, that's in Electronic City, the showroom. And the service part, they have really given me like what I expected from them. Mm-hmm. They really do a good servicing. So I prefer like after 2000 kilometers, each and every 2000 kilometer, I give my bike for servicing, and they do a real good service. They also let me know if any part of the my bike is required to be replaced or not. Like after 25,000 kilometers, I had to change my one of my tires, the back tires I had to change. So they always let me know whether I have to change a single part if required. They will call me and they will just tell me. So I am pretty satisfied with the kind of service they give me. And there are a lot of showrooms in Bangalore, but I prefer this 9-star because of the kind of service they have given after selling me the bike. So they take it like their own bike and they do the service. So that's one thing I should appreciate, and that gave me more confidence, like I should go over there. Maybe a minor problem is there in my bike, I go only in the showroom and give it to them, because I trust them a lot right now by the service they have already given me. And like almost per month I have to give my bike for servicing, and the service cost is around, maximum it goes to 2k if I have to replace a part, or else it is up to 1k. So I think it's quite satisfying and it's like quite affordable for at least for me. So I think it's really great. With this cheap amount, they provide such a good service.
Now, after having clocked so many kilometers, you definitely have a very deep understanding of the bike. So finally, do you suggest any changes or modifications to make the ownership experience any better?
Regarding the modification, I didn't do much of a modification with my bike, but the thing that I missed was in 2015 Gixxer didn't have this dual disc system, so the rear and the front one. So I had only front one, and I had a drum brake at the rear one. So that was the only drawback I felt at that point of time. But in 2017 they have already launched with the double disc as well as FI engine and ABS facility. So I think there's nothing much they can modify. The bike looks awesome the way it is, and with all this modification recently, whatever they have launched, I think it's a super bike. It's really good. I, after such a long experience, I would say at the range of 150cc bikes, I think Gixxer is one of the best bike that anyone can have. So I won't say people to give a second thought. I would say if you like Gixxer, just go for it. So that's as per my experience. And with respect to my bike, I have just added one extra tank pad That's the only thing I have added, and few stickers. Other than that, I love the bike as it was given to me from the showroom, and I don't want to make any kind of modification because I just love the bike I have right now.
All right, Anik, thank you so much for being on the show. It was a pleasure talking to you.
Thank you, Swati. I really appreciate that you gave me the opportunity where I can say people about my experience I had with Gixxer. I really love my bike as because this was people say like for love at first sight, it's not possible, but I had that one with my bike and I think this will always remain my first sight love. I really appreciate and really thank you for giving me this opportunity, and I hope whatever experience I had, it might help people in taking a good decision while selecting Gixxer. So it will give them a good concept, how is the performance of the bike and what kind of advantage they can have if they purchase a Gixxer itself. Thank you once again.
So the Suzuki Gixxer SF with its 155cc heart never really disappoints, and it's ideal for our riding conditions. It's light, efficient and easy to own. If you have any questions, do comment them below. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button for all the latest reviews. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.